Welcome to Chemistry Online Classes. Today I am going to discuss electromeric effect. So last class we have completed inductive effect. Today we are discussing electromeric effect. And it is a temporary effect. When you are taking an inductive effect, it is a permanent effect. But electromeric effect is temporary effect. It is observed in multiple bond systems. Multiple bonded system like alkenes, alkynes, whenever the double bond is there, so we can see electromeric effect. So what is electromeric effect? It is a, in presence of polar reagent, the pi bonded electrons are migrated to one of the atom. That we call it as electromeric effect. Let's take a and b, which is having one pi bond, because we are observing this electromeric effect in the multiple bonded system. If I bring a one polar reagent p, what happens? Whatever the pi bond is there, this can be migrated any one of the atom which is attached to the double bond. As a result, we get B negative charge and A is positive charge. The pi electrons are migrated to one of the atom, and this effect is called as electromeric effect. And this is a temporary effect. In presence of polar reagents, we can see this kind of displacement of pi electrons. If we remove polar reagent from the system, again this B will give pi electrons to here, and which will form a AB. That's why I said it is a temporary effect. In presence of polar reagents, we can see this kind of displacement, and this we call it as electromeric effect. And electromeric effect is two types, again plus E and minus E. Electromeric effect we generally represented with a capital E. It is a denotation of the electromeric effect, E. Again, it is two types, plus E effect, positive electromeric effect, and negative electromeric effect. When we call it as positive electromeric effect and when we call it as negative electromeric effect is, for example, I am taking here positive electromeric effect, A double bond B. In presence of polar reagent, let us assume it is migrated in this fashion. The pi bonded electrons are migrated in this fashion, B minus and A positive. If I am bringing an electrophile, it is a polar reagent, what happens? The B negative, which will give to the electrophile, which forms an addition product. Now what happens here? The pi bonding electrons displaces toward the polar reagent, and this effect we call it as plus E effect. The pi electrons displaced toward the attacking reagent is called as plus E effect. And other case, minus E effect, when we call it as negative electromeric effect, is the pi bonded electrons displaced away to the attacking reagent, we call it as negative electromeric effect. If I take a C double bond O group, carbon double bond O, carbonyl group, if I take, if I am bringing a polar reagent, let us assume nucleophile, what happened here? The pi bonded polarization will take place and oxygen and carbon will get positive charge. After polarization, negative charge on the oxygen and positive charge on the carbon. Here the pi bonded electrons are shifted towards the oxygen side, and whatever the polar reagent will go and attack to the carbon, which forms nucleophilic addition product. Okay, here what happens, the whatever the pi bonded electrons are there, which is displaced away to the attacking reagent. Attacking reagent is nucleophile. It is the pi bonded electrons are shifted towards the oxygen side, and this we call it as negative electromeric effect. Here the pi bonded electrons are shifted towards the attacking reagent. It is called as plus E effect. And this effect we observe only in presence of polar reagent. If I am removing electrophile here and nucleophile here, again it will come back and it will form a pi bond. That's why this effect is temporary effect. Next, I would like to compare the both inductive effect and electromeric effect. One side I am taking inductive effect, another side I am taking a electromeric effect. If we compare, inductive effect is permanent effect, electromeric effect is temporary effect. Only in presence of polar reagent we are seeing electromeric effect, that's why it is taking as a temporary effect. And where we have observed inductive effect is sigma electrons, sigma bonded electrons displacement takes place in inductive effect. But in the electromeric effect, the pi bonded electrons displacement takes place towards one of the atom. As a result of displacement in inductive effect, always we get partial charges, that is delta positive or delta negative. But in the case of electromeric effect, if polar reagent is approaching, always we get positive and negative charge. It is a completely full charged species which is forms in presence of polar reagent. At the magnitude of this inductive effect will be present up to the short distance, and we have discussed that more than second carbon onwards the inductive effect is most of the time it is negligible. But this effect lasts over long range distance. If you have a some unsaturated compound is present, let's take a, this is the example, what happens, this will be polarized here, this will be polarized in this fashion. That means if you have take a conjugated system, the electromeric effect will be there over larger distance, but inductive effect we can see C1 or C2 carbon maximum. And in the inductive effect, the electrons, whatever the bonded pair of electrons which are present, which will be there in the original orbitals. But in the case of electromeric effect, the electrons are completely shifted toward the one of the atom which is occupies the new orbitals. And these are the main difference between inductive effect and electromeric effect. Usually inductive effect we have seen in the hydrocarbon case, saturated hydrocarbons or any group which is attached. But electromeric effect we see in the case of unsaturated systems.